my God! On today's show, Jim Parsons from The Big Bang Theory swings by the studio to come clean about a secret Twitter account. Ooh, secrets. Then new correspondent Kelly Beckett lets her inner audio file out at NAMM. She'll get her hands on the latest cutting-edge audio tech, including a portable studio that records to your iPhone. Insane. And MMA fighter Ronda Rousey flips me over in an interview. The applause peaked about 2 seconds before we actually cut to the beat. But I'm telling you, at home, man, a groundswell of energy in the studio. And it's easy to understand why.
Because it is the attack week in the day.
I mean, that is... There were dots. You connected them right there.
Yep.
Boom. Huge week. Exciting week.
It was a huge week. I got attacked by a jacket this week.
That is true.
It just came right at me. I know. I don't even know how that happened.
It is inanimate.
And then it attacked you.
It did attack you. I lost the battle with this one. It's on me.
It looks good, Kevin. Yeah. You look very nice.
It's like mating with an animal in like the Avatar world. It's like once the jacket chooses you, you wrestle, and now it's on.
It's on.
This is it. I'm bound for life to this jacket.
We also tried Pizza Prince this week.
Oh, yeah. It's almost as fun as eating actual printer ink. Explain for those who didn't see those scallions.
It's these,
the wrap scallion
these
variety.
Things that you put on your pizza. You're supposed to put it on your pizza. We've also put it on fettuccine alfredo and some gazpacho soup. It's supposed
man,
to melt on it. And then you eat it and you don't really taste it. Except for you do a little. The pizza I didn't mind. The fettuccine I didn't mind. The gazpacho soup I wanted to throw up. Because it didn't melt. It's
the
cold.
The fact that you didn't mind the first two is really what's impressive.
It was pizza.
It tasted just like powdered hate. And we had it pretty easy on the pizza and the pasta.
Yeah.
Sarah Underwood went for the Pizza Prince roll-up and jammed it. Hey, Sarah Underwood, by the way, everybody.
Hey, Sarah.
Yeah, speaking of that, I thought it'd be a fun idea to try, just without no food, if it's edible, try the Pizza Prince. It was a bad idea. It was not good. It may be edible, but it was not good. Anyways, let's talk about the feed. What's coming up?
Yes.
Okay, what do we got?
Okay. I got this for you. Remember that site, Mega Upload?
Yeah.
Well, now its users are filing a lawsuit against the U.S. government.
What?
Yep.
Is Pat Sajak representing them?
He's coming up. We'll talk about him.
And you're still lurking. You're lurking.
I thought the lurking was over.
To be honest, Sajak has the lurker face.
That is a really creepy face.
I'm getting double lurked right now. That's cool.
You like to buy well?
Learn how the massive solar storm this week is actually making science better. And everyone's this first lurker here, everyone's favorite wheel-watching game show host, used to be drunk on the job.
What?
It's all coming up in the feed.
Now
back to you guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you, Sarah. So Kevin went to NAMM this past weekend.
I did.
You saw a bunch of cool things there, right?
Yes, I did.
Tell us what you told.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
A bunch of cool things.
NAMM is a playground for musicians and those who aspire to be musicians. Mm-hmm. And what's nice is that, again, the barrier to entry is pretty much nil. Do you have an iPhone?
Mm-hmm.
Great, you can be a musician.
I do now.
There's 1,001 products and pieces of software and things you can plug into other things that you can get off of store shelves that will make you a musician at the touch of a button. And that's what's so exciting. And then if you actually are a talented and proficient musician
at
an instrument, just like you.
I play the tambourine and the triangle.
Rock's a mean triangle.
I know.
They have all sorts of stuff there, but that's not important. What's important is that Kelly Beckett also
went
to NAMM.
Our new correspondent.
That's it.
And twos, shred on an axe, or pound those skins, NAMM Show has everything to do with musical gear. And it's one big party. DJ, throw me a beat!
That's me.
Now, you can't come Amsterdam without stopping at the Pioneer booth. My personal favorite has to be this here. It's tight, it's compact, it's the Pioneer VDJ Ergo. Basically, it's got the same touch and the feel as CDJs, as you can see here. It all has the same features. You've got your play, you've got your cues here, you've got your tempo at the side. But you know the cool thing about this? You don't even have to touch your laptop. This works for Serato, this works for Tracker, this works for DJ on iTunes. And for $6.99, I personally feel you cannot go wrong. So I think all that's left for me to do is whack on some tunes and let's get this party started. Check this out. It's a teeny tiny pocket synth. It's the Chord Monotron. And if you want to just space out in your room, listen to this. Sounds like space. It's alive. Alive. Nah, it's not. It's just a synthesizer. A Buchla 200D module synthesizer. So basically, this does... I don't know what this does. I need to bring in the expert. There is so many crazy wires here. Please tell me what this does.
Okay, so this is essentially a modular synthesizer. It's been made since the 1960s. It's one of the first synthesizers. Here we have a couple of oscillators, they're called. Okay. And you can choose a note value for these. And then we have other things. We have a sequencer up here, a filter here, so you can control the color of the sound. This would be used by a lot of electronic musicians. Uh-huh. People like Deadmau5, Aphex Twin, Alessandro Cortini.
How much would this set you back?
It would set you back around 30,000.
So I think I need to give this a try and see if I can create some new sounds. This might not be head-bopping music, but this is serious science. This is the Tascam IU2 for Apple devices. Now say you're in Starbucks. You just come up with the most amazing idea to record a song. You just pull this out of your backpack, hook up your mic, hook it up to your iPhone. There you have it, instant recording of your most amazing song. You can hook it up to any instrument, say a keyboard, an acoustic guitar, electric guitar. Now, don't feel bad if you're not an Apple user. This actual USB will fit into any PC device. The Tascam also has its own app for recording called the Porto Studio, or you can use GarageBand. Any recording app will work on this. So this is a really cool, sexy, slimline recording input device. For $149, it's out the end of February. You really can't go wrong with this, guys. It can even record my favorite recording artist. Baby, baby. No? I found so many cool stuff today here on the NAMM show floor. And best of all, I found my rock and roll boyfriend. Serenade me, sweet princess.
Hey, this is Chris Hollandoni, segment producer on Attack of the Show. And coming up, we've got the best the internet has to offer on Around the Net. Then we head to the Asian Underground and check out Eastern DVDs, City Hunter, Soul Eater, Ultraman, and we check out Chris Gore falling on his ass.
Down the best videos of the week.
Yeah. I know. Up first.
Construction workers catcalling the videos.
Yeah! Let's see those clips! Oh! Some of the whams!
Kevin, this means quiet.
Does it?
Okay, so let's try this. Shout, shout, shout.
Yeah! Quiet!
Oh. Up first, a crosswalk in Russia!
Okay.
What?
Russian childcare system really consists of attentive drivers with working car horns. That's all they got. Am I right?
That's right.
Any Russians in the studio?
Hey, Kevin.
They're too drunk to care.
In Russia, that's how they decide which babies will grow up to be corrupt alcoholics.
We good on that one? That was all the energy I had left. Next. When you live in a place without reality television, you have to make your own fun.
And you can do it with just a very large tire and an even larger hill.
Whoa. What?
But that's good, though. That's just good, natural, clean fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess, except for the giant rubber tire that's not going to decompose for, like, millions of years. Yeah. And will probably kill whatever wildlife was living in that, and probably killed a camper that was in a sleeping bag on the way down or whatever. We don't really know for sure.
Thanks, Debbie Downer. Oh. You know, nobody really knows what happens on farms.
What?
Hey, Dale. Hey, Dale. Yep.
The cow is barely running. He's like, and it's like,
what?
What? Like, it's true.
Chris Gore here at Spin Fusion in Los Angeles, where I come to find the latest and greatest in DVDs. On this edition of Asian Underground, prepare to have wisdom knocked into your brain with a high kick. And a high kick. Ow. Oh, my jeans. Here to help me with everything but high kicks is our very own Asian cinema expert, Jeff Wong. Now, Jeff, today we're talking about popular TV series from the Far East, starting with City Hunter. Tell me what the story is.
Well, City Hunter follows sort of a revenge story where this kid whose father was sort of assassinated as part of a government cover-up conspiracy grows up as a soldier to where his mission is to infiltrate the Blue House and find all these government officials who plotted the assassination of his father.
Okay, so it's just like Boardwalk Empire, but it's set in Korea, right?
No, actually, it's nothing like Boardwalk Empire. You gotta think of it more as something like 24 or something like The Bourne Identity if it were a long TV show. However, it is a Korean drama and you kind of get your soap opera fix while you're getting your spy thriller.
You know I love anime, Jeff, but Soul Eater looks like this brutal, violent cartoon that's definitely not for kids.
Well, Soul Eater follows the exploits of these two students who study at the Grim Reaper's Academy for sort of demon hunting. It does have elements for kids in it where these kids are students and they're trying to learn how to defeat demons, but it also has the elements of horror strewn through it because, well, they are in fact hunting demons.
That's what's strange about Soul Eater is it has this delightful, colorful cartoon characters and look that's for kids, yet it's got this brutal digital blood splattering everything.
Anime is never afraid to try anything. With this one in particular, the cheapest way to make it is to integrate digital imagery into it. So you do have hand-drawn characters mixed with CG effects, and it's the quickest way they can get these series out.
I can't pull the trigger on him.
Okay, now we have Ultraman, the complete series. I loved this show as a kid. What's in this box set?
Well, this box set is just that, the complete series. It has the entire series that ran from 1966 through 1967, follows the exploits of the pilot Hayata, who was a member of the Science Patrol. And after crashing his spaceship into the Ultraman, he gets the mantle of Ultraman and has to save the Earth from, well, giant monsters.
Now, what's funny about Ultraman is he's like a character that's the worst commercial for solar power ever. I mean, every time he'd turn into Ultraman, he'd have maybe 5 minutes to fight the monster, but that's it, out of power.
So what I think was actually great about that is if he only has 3 minutes to do it, he has to sort of time it right because he's going to run out of energy. The show also gave him a weakness that his energy was limited throughout the series, and it sort of ended with Ultraman kind of running out of energy and maybe not returning ever.
Thanks again, Jeff, for your gifts from the Far East. Yet again, you saved the day. Jeff and I will be back again on the next edition of Asian Underground.
All the news you need to know.
January 27th, and what a week! As we reported, American officials airdropped into New Zealand to arrest the founder of Mega Upload on charges of massive media piracy on his birthday, no less. The site's colorful founder plans on fighting the charges, and apparently, users of the site are fighting too. A group is building a list of all of the legitimate file sharers who have used Mega Upload and plans to sue the FBI over lost files. Anyone who wants in on the action can sign up at their website. Just don't expect to make it through the airport without a TSA cavity search ever again. And as you know, the planet was hit by a massive solar storm this week. And while there were a few minor problems with power grids and spacecraft, we learned that scientists are getting much better at predicting these storms. Their estimated arrival time for this cosmic event was only off by 13 minutes, which is pretty awesome when you consider they're trying to predict the actions of a giant flaming ball of plasma from 93 million miles away. Now, this is important as solar flares and storms are expected to increase as the sun moves into a more active phase of its life cycle. And if you're worried about that, you should just cover your windows in tinfoil. The internet tells me that works, so. And finally, ever wonder how game show hosts keep up that happy-go-lucky exterior?
Yeah.
Well, if Wheel of Fortune's Pat Sajak is any indication, it's probably the booze. That's right, the veteran TV host says he and Vanna were Sajacked up back in the day, quote, when it was a different show. Apparently, they would go get so drunk at a Mexican place on margaritas that they, quote, had trouble recognizing the alphabet. Congrats, Pat. You just won a trip to sunny rehab. But the bigger shock to me is that Sajak can host that show sober. Teach me how to host sober, please. I'm Sarah Underwood, and you've just been fed.
Hey, it's Chris Alandoni again, and coming up, the new face of women's MMA, Ronda Rousey. She's coming in for a flippin' good time with Kevin, and then threatens to choke everyone in the studio.
Yeah. Amazing Nerdo asked, who in the hell is Gutenberg?
America's been asking that since 1992.
Invented the press.
Yes, Gutenberg invented the printing press. Very important. One true fool asked, how long do you think it takes before gore in a DVD shop replaces bull in a China shop?
Chris fell down.
Right now, for me, that is the new statement. That's the new way of saying it.
He was doing a kick, maybe got up this high, and slipped and fell.
Why don't we let the hilarious visuals speak for themselves?
We can watch that.
It's so good.
We'll see that.
Prepare to have wisdom knocked into your brain with a high kick. I mean, a high kick.
Proof that no one over 25 should wear Heelys. I'm sorry. Just Don't have any. What were you going to say? What was your favorite part of that? The part where he fell down?
He does it twice. Well, the part that he fell down, obviously, but he's like, with a high kick. With a high kick.
It doesn't even go that high. Run it one more time. Just run it one more time.
Yeah. There to have wisdom knocked into your brain with a high kick. I mean, a high kick.
Taking out bobbleheads and slap bracelet stand on the way down. We do love you, Chris Gore. Get well. We think he's going to pull through.
I think he'll be just fine.
I mean, either way.
He'll be fine.
But we hope.
And D Sharp 1 says, something about a woman who can beat my ass is hot. You got your ass beat, right?
I wouldn't go that far.
I think, first of all,
it was a sucker throw. No bell was rung. No ref said, let's get it on, and slapped his latex together. You know what I mean? So that was a sucker's throw.
But you're lucky that was the case.
You guys didn't see what happened during the commercial break because we did one of those poster style stare downs. One of these.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Maybe that was going to end in a kiss, but I was. Please welcome Ronda Rousey, everybody. I'm all torn asunder because I know where this segment ends. I'm staring at a crash mat right now, and it's laughing at me because I'm made of porcelain and sadness.
And it's a thin one, too.
But we'll get into that. Yeah, we'll get into that in a second. I want to talk about your big fight coming up. What are you, first of all, what are you doing on a live television show talking about this? Shouldn't you be punching things and screaming like mad in a gym?
I was already punching things this morning.
Okay, good.
Yes, I fit this in between, so we fit it in the schedule between punching stuff. And, it's just stuff that you gotta do, you know, I have to kind of schedule all the media stuff around all the training, you know, it's necessary for the fight, and it's part of the job.
And Misha Tate?
If you pronounced it wrong, I would have loved that, but you actually pronounced it right.
Oh, yeah. Well, Misha Tate is in for a real rude awakening because when I scroll your Wikipedia, it looks like someone got lazy and just copy and pasted win, 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 armbar, 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 technical submission, parentheses, armbar. You like snapping arms.
My mom likes snapping arms, actually.
So it runs in the family.
Yeah. She taught me the armbar things instead of giving me Barbie.
Such a better choice.
Yeah, in the long run it was. At the time I was like, I want Barbies, but now I'm just like, you know what?
You don't want Barbies, you want Ken's arm to be snapped in half.
Yeah.
You kick him out of the Malibu beach house, make him cry.
Well, I saw on Twitter that you said you could armbar me, so.
I was vague. I said that I would submit you within 2 minutes of the interview, and so I've already lost, I think. So I'm already done. But no, I mean, your highlights are incredible. You'd think that your opponents must know that this is coming,
yep.
Right?
But there's nothing they could do about it.
There's gotta be. There's gotta be. And to prove that you are the as you say, the most dangerous woman in the world or in the country, or how do you?
I think I'm the most dangerous unarmed woman in the planet.
Yeah. Okay.
Like literally, I could kill every single person in this room with my bare hands if I had them one at a time. I wouldn't do that, but I'm just saying.
To be fair, this
I could do it.
This room in particular, if you combine all our strength, it would be like a part-time employee at the Geek Squad. It's really not that. It's picking on sickly children, but that is fair. But to prove how amazing you are actually going to beat up a cyborg, I was told.
I was until she got popped for steroids. Big surprise.
Yeah, what happened with that? Cyborg is she the number one ranked right now? Or
she was at 135
but now a big
until she got stripped of her title and everything like that, and deservingly so. You know, don't cheat.
Yeah, absolutely. And you called her out. I love the Twitter battle you guys had. Can you walk us for those who don't know walking through that tale?
I wouldn't have said anything if she hadn't insulted my girl Gina, which you've had on here before. Mm-hmm. She put up a thing on here on her Twitter, and it was like a Photoshop picture of Gina after they fought. You know, with I'm sure this is the first time. This is not the first time Cyborg has used Photoshop, but she photoshopped
she uses
her
the
face.
Nudge tool or the healing brush to
the shrink tool
to hide any awkward bulges in the ring. I got it
exactly like that. And she put next victim Ronda, which I would have expected that. I wouldn't have said anything. Unless she put a picture of Gina on there, and I was like, you know what? No one would know who you are if it wasn't for Gina. You know, if you hadn't beaten her, no one would know who you are. If you weren't doping, you wouldn't have beaten her. And she was nice to her about that. She didn't say anything like really bad about her doping. And I was just pissed off. I was like, you know what? You don't just have a for posting that picture of Gina, you cheater. And you know what? Someone needed to say it because Gina's just too nice. So I'm fine with being the mean one. And that's low. And plus, you can't intimidate someone with a photoshopped picture. I was like, oh, yeah, I could beat you up like that, even though I couldn't beat up that chick like that. I'm like, I could show you a non-photoshopped picture of a girl's elbow looking like a flamingo knee. That's a lot more intimidating than that one.
I love it. I have tried to Photoshop myself to make myself look more intimidating. You're right. It doesn't work. It doesn't work at all. The background's all bulgy behind me. I'm not very good at it. It's not really good. People are like, what are you now? You Photoshopped it. You look like you're 112 pounds. That's cute. Do you ever get in fights outside of the ring?
I have, but they're not usually worth it. I got jumped by a bunch of guys in a movie theater, and they sued me for assault.
What?
Yeah. Because...
Wait, this is like an assigned seating thing at the Arclight? Because I know those movie nerds can get crazy.
No, it was some random movie theater. We're watching Juno, you know.
Okay,
Who feels violent in Juno?
It's a real rough crowd.
It was
that
like
goes
a vague group of people in the theater that's like shouting obscene things and just being like
at Juno?
Yes.
Okay.
Like, you know, like Jennifer Garner comes on, oh, I do her, oh, she's hot.
Stabbed at Failure to Watch, so I get it. Yeah. It really.
So this girl was wearing the mini skirt with Ugg boots, which I already can't stand that whole look to
begin
with.
Did you break her leg?
Wait. So she put her little Uggs up on my seat and was like nudging my head with it. And I'm like, you know what? This is a good movie. I'm going to wait for this movie to end. And then I'm going to take this girl's boot off and I'm going to throw it. And I'm going to tell her to ask her mother to get some manners. So I did that. And then it was like four couples or something like that. So all the guys cut me off in the aisle and they're like, go get her boot. Da, da, da. And
standing up for their woman.
Yeah. Okay. And I happened to look like a girl that day. So they didn't know what was happening. And so I tried to get past and they pushed me. And the one guy pushed me back and I started punching him. And his friend came around grabbing a hand through him and all this stuff. And it's funny thing, I was wearing flip-flops through all this and I lost my shoe in the middle of the fight, which I thought that was kind of ironic that everyone was just losing shoes.
Right.
And
but no one chucked your flip-flops across the
field. No. It came off during a maneuver.
So speaking of, let's say I'm the guy in the theater now. I'm kicking the seat. What are you going to do, pretty lady? What are you going to do, lady face?
Well, you want to see it in a minute.
No, I really don't want to see. Let's do it, though.
You ready?
You've been hip-tossing idiots like me for a long while, but what is the secret to a quality throw?
Leverage. And I'm not that big. He's just a little man. Okay.
Yeah, no, I'm incredibly tiny. We've established that. I am Seacrest Light.
Relax.
Let's go.
The more you
resist, I see what you're doing there.
The
I got
it. It's gonna hurt. You
okay.
Ready?
I've said that 1,000 times. Okay. Yep. Yep. I'm just. Whoa. Whoa.
Just get out of my chest. Whoa. Are you okay?
I'm great. Thanks to Ronda Rousey. Is she still here? Hey. No, oh, that was awesome. Thank you so much. Great. Ronda Rousey, everybody. She fights in the Strikeforce Women's Bantamweight title on March 3rd. Do not put your feet on her theater seat.
March is a long ways away, but that doesn't mean you can't start getting excited about the return of Ninja Warrior. Yeah! To facebook.com/ninjawarrior.
Hey, it's Chris Hollandoni again, and still ahead, we got Jim Parsons from The Big Bang Theory. He comes in to talk about the wonders of the internet, his secret Twitter account, and his dismal fantasy football season.
This Karate Kid wants to be king of the demo. So what happens next? Does he successfully break the board? Does he miss and kick the guy holding the board? Or does he kick the board out of his hand and it hits a lady in the face? Find out when we return. This Karate Kid wants to be king of the demo. So what happens next? Does he successfully break the board? Does he miss and kick the guy holding the board? Or does he kick the board out of his hand and it hits a lady in the face? At this rate, the black eye belt will be his in no time.
Next guest, I'm very excited. He has a show that Big Bang the crap out of American Idol in the ratings, and I love that.
I'm Dr. Sheldon Cooper, and welcome to the premiere episode of Sheldon Cooper Presents Fun with Flags. Over the next 52 weeks, you and I are going to explore the dynamic world of vexillology.
Hang on, Dr. C. What's vexillology?
Vexillology is the study of flags.
Cool. I think I just learned something.
Did you have fun doing it?
I'll say.
Please welcome back Jim Parsons, everybody.
Thank you for having me.
Pleasure. You have been to this set many times. I have
had the pleasure to sit next to you.
No, you've always managed to be gone when I'm here.
And grow your questions.
But the set has grown since it's different.
It's grown up a little bit.
Same
it's
size, evolved. But a different shape.
We got a gift card to a Best Buy, so we just went crazy in the plasmas. That was it.
A good Christmas present.
So congrats to us for the set. Congrats to you on 100 episodes.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. You're in... fifth season now.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, syndication is when other networks are going to just run this thing
all
the time. Yes. Anytime you're going to be, the Housewives at 11 a.m. are going to love it.
That's right.
Stoners at 3 a.m. are going to watch it for the fourth time.
That's what I'm hoping.
All across the country. So now you're set. You're done. Right? That's got to feel amazing.
Are you saying I should retire?
No. Well, you can if you want, right? Now you have that security and that ability.
Maybe.
F you money is what I'm saying. That's what the kids say.
Yeah, well, I don't know. It's hard for me. If I have F you money, it's hard for me to accept that I have that yet, you know. I feel that I honestly, there's a really part of my brain that worries, and it's getting better as the years go by, but I still get concerned that at the end of this show, I'll be back on unemployment and that... I don't know where I'll be hired again next.
But that's a real.
Oh no, it's not pity.
By the way, he's not going to be back on unemployment.
No, that's the truth of it.
It's going to be okay.
I mean, unless I do something wild and crazy, and by that I mean really crazy and probably drug-addled, then I won't.
Yeah, but then you launch a comedy tour around it and put it on stick cam, and the kids love you. You know what
you
I mean?
You really have me a made man. I like
winning.
This.
You're
yeah,
set.
I'm winning no matter what.
Speaking of those fans online, the Twitter kids want you on Twitter. Are so bad, they ask for it. You're not on there.
Well,
officially.
I am a little bit. No, I'm not officially. I have an account, and it's not under my name. It's under a pseudonym, I guess we say. I don't tweet. I just follow. And it's a few sports things I follow and a few political things I follow and, like, a news thing that I follow.
So you're lurking on Twitter.
I'm getting access to news. Twitter's an excellent way to get, like news feed and,
sure.
and updates really quick or whatever.
I know exactly what someone thought about their ham sandwich. Done.
That I don't care about. See,
okay.
That's the problem
okay, got it,
I have
got
with
it.
Twitter. And more importantly, I don't want to share that with anybody. If I like my ham sandwich, that's my business. You know, but I have started putting out a couple of little tweets I tweeted to two sports figures who, Houston Texans, who put up a hell of an effort in a losing battle, but I didn't want them to feel discouraged, and so I wrote them.
I thought you were going to say you flamed them left
no,
and right on Twitter.
No, I said you were incredible today, you know, and I don't want them to feel discouraged and leave the sport. And but I do.
That's not how trolling works on Twitter.
I'm not trolling.
But no one creates a fake account to say positive things about
people
on Twitter.
It's not important that it's from me. I just want them to know somebody cares. And then I tweeted, do you know the Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords who recently retired?
Yeah.
She was shot last
yeah.
year. She put together her video to retire, and it was really moving and really well done. And so I tweeted to her that I really thought it was a beautiful video, and I'd be thinking of her as she kept recovering.
Behind the anonymous veil, you're the sweetest guy on the internet. That's really
well. I don't want to use it for the anonymous slams because that's so easy and it's so common. You know
right.
what I mean? And there's plenty of people that slam things, even me in our show or whatever, and they don't have a face or whatever, and that's fine. It's free country, but it's still, you know, I'd rather not use it for that.
Right. But now, so if you're tweeting to football players, I'm assuming then that means you're watching the game. Or you're following the ESPN Twitter feed.
Yeah.
What are you a big footballer?
I wasn't. You know, obviously, I've never played any sports. But I very early on in my life, I got interested in tennis, watching it. I understood this, like, I felt like this mano-a-mano competitive thing. I could really understand that
sure.
mental, emotional aspect to it. And I kind of translated that for me into team sports, where I see the solo effort or even a team effort, you know. And there's something to me really moving about that, mm-hmm. and oddly relatable in my own life. That sounds strange, I know, but I really do enjoy it. And so football was kind of my final quest of sport that I hadn't gone after to.
Are you a passive watcher though, or do you do the
fantasy? I've become more now. I'm fantasy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm with.
You crossed over the dark side.
I did. I love it. It's really one of my favorite things in the world now. There's nothing like in the middle of the day going, I don't want to think about any of the crap I'm supposed to, and I'd like to know who's not starting this week. You know, and I go there. I'm with Kunal in a league with Kunal, who's on my show, and I was in last place.
Oh, congratulations!
Thank you. I think I get first pick next year in the draft, though.
Okay. I know some leagues will do like a booby prize. Either you get a couple bucks or you get an RC car. Or
no, I got no booby prize. But okay. first pick next year would make me very happy.
That'd be
a
huge
prize.
Yeah. So all right. So positive lurking chicken soup for the trolling soul on Twitter.
Yes.
Fantasy football. What other uses are you finding for this crazy internet of ours?
Well, you know, funnily, I recently purchased a piano, which is a big purchase for me, but I had room in my house for it, and I had played for years, but I hadn't taken lessons in like 18 years, and you can take lessons online. Like, I had sheet music for Debussy's Clair de Lune, this classical piece, and I was like, it's a beautiful song, I wanted to play it. There is a man who teaches it measure by measure on YouTube, and I'm about halfway through it right now. And then the other thing I found
was... Wait, does he have the crazy bearded, braids
he's not
in
bearded.
His beard and a tie-dye shirt and a wizard hat?
No, he's some man in Philadelphia who is a trained musician, obviously. It's a hell of a lesson. And then I wanted to play something the other day. I had a hankering for it, and I thought, you know what? And sure enough, you can go online, download the music, and print it out, and suddenly you have sheet music. Oh, I know I sound like an old man who's just learned how to use it, but it's an amazing thing.
And, by the way, that Werther's, they've got a website as well. You can see how they're made. That's delicious. Just unwrap them and put your cats off the piano and play. That would sound eld, but
no.
But finding sheet music is, like, if you've ever played or you know, it's...
Well, you don't have to go to the store
You got to go to a store. It's
and
always awkward
then,
at a store that sells sheet music.
And even
always.
Then, they may not have it, you know, and or it's just the vocal part and you want the whatever.
This internet thing is going to take
it's
off.
Really going to work.
It
is.
And I truly hope, I guarantee you, there are millions of people, not watching us, there's 12, but I mean, there are people out there that want to know what you had for lunch. So if we can get you on Twitter, we would happily set up an account
sure.
for you.
I will tell you today I had a turkey sandwich with avocado and mayo.
Get that out there. Create the account now. Get it verified. The world has a right to know. Turkey sand with the avo. Jim Parsons, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Real pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
You guys can catch the Big Bang Theory Thursday night on CBS.
Hey, it's Chris again, and coming up, we got a lurker-ish behind-the-scenes moment of the week.
Kevin just ate the entire waffle in like 5 seconds.
I'm not finished the damn thing. I need a shirt.
All right, that was a...
Coming up on Attack of the Show... Actor Michael B. Jordan will be here with his mind-blowing superhero movie, Chronicle. Then the world's hottest gamer, Adrian Curry, stops by with a new season of The Tester. Plus, Chris Gore beams down a verdict on Star Trek The Next Generation Next Level Blu-ray Collection on DVDuesday. Then Weston Scott goes to the SHOT Show in Vegas to check out their arsenal, including rifles, handguns, and even a grenade launcher. And we'll show off all the tech you need to fill your man cave for the big game in Gadgetron. See it starting Monday. It's time for the behind-the-scenes moment of the week! Kevin, this whole week, has been lurking during the feed. He's a very talented lurker.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. You are one of the best.
It's a passive trait for us Portuguese. If you don't know what it is, take a look.
The subject is irrelevant when it comes to lurking. You gotta be stealthy, you gotta be silent, you gotta make really unbecoming faces. You wanna think like child clown scary, and you wanna somehow partially obscure your body. That's the point of the lurk. With that said, having Sarah Underwood as a target to lurk, amazing.
This is a small studio. He found every little nook and corner that he could get into. He is a quiet lurker. He is good, he's done this before, guys.
You just been lurked.
Friends.
Today we totally got the Tizitis threads for you. Let's do it. Rugged is always in, and Carhartt is just the brand to add that grizzled look to your coat closet. Once thought to only be for farmers and people who want to look like farmers, Carhartt has modernized their flavor. Just check out some of their new digs, like this Series 1889 jacket. This military-inspired coat is great for looking snazzy while outdoorsing or indoorsing. But if you would like to stick to their classic look, the sandstone hooded jacket is what you need to weather the elements. It's Sherpa-lined, even! They killed a Sherpa to make this coat! I kid, it just means it's very warm. And if climate change has already hit your neck of the woods, don't worry, because Carhartt has you covered. Their 2012 spring line is about to drop, and this waterproof shoreline jacket is both functional and fashionable. Go to Carhartt.com, where their jackets run anywhere from $85 to $175. Do you need another T-shirt a day website? Don't answer, I know you do. SurePunch.com launched last year and they shuck their wares for only 10 bucks. It's like they're giving them away, y'all. The designs are inspired from everything pop culture, such as video games, movies, television, music, and comic books. But think fast, because the shirts are only up for one day. Every 24 hours, it's like a game of awesome shirt roulette. Take, for example, this Porky Pig Gamorrean Guard or this sick, nasty Arkham Asylum shirt. And don't be bummed, but you probably missed out on the Keep Hyrule Green and Pokewalk t-shirts. I'm sorry, but look on the bright side. You won't miss any more now that you know about Shirt Punch. And besides the amazing artists they work with, they even collaborate with celebrities. Warwick Davis from Life's Too Short helped design this magical Willow t-shirt. Make sure to check back each day to see what's being offered up, because if you snooze, you lose. And speaking of punching in t-shirts, Tokyo 5 is one of the best MMA clothing apparel brands out there. Unlike most MMA brands, there's no shiny lettering, no skulls, just some really slick duds. And they happen to sponsor some MMA fighters. If you're still riding out the plaid wave, Tokyo 5 has it. But what is super refreshing are their t-shirts, which use simple Japanese calligraphy to emphasize their samurai aesthetic. And while you're on the site, you might as well check out their long sleeves, hoodies, and this swaggerific denim jacket. And that's just the tops. Tokyo 5 also has some killer pants. Pick whether you want slim or straight and what type of distressed denim. But maybe you're in the market for some corduroys, which is fine by me if you're rocking these. And they have more than just shirts and pants. Tokyo 5 has training gear as well as accessories like duffel bags, hats, and belts. Head on over to Tokyo5brand.com to deck yourself out in some not-so-douchey attire. We did it, guys! We got you some jackets, t-shirts, and everything else. Go forth and be threaded. Thanks to Chris Gore, Jeff Wong, Kelly Beckett, Ronda Rousey, Jim Parsons.
Unsung hero of the week. Well, yeah, you guys were all amazing, but the real unsung hero was the killer jacket.
No!